Hello everyone and welcome back to another PowerPoint animation tutorial. In this video we are going to make an Apple logo animated background using the spin animation effect. So, let's get started, and here we have a total of 17 shape objects, and we use the spin effect for all of them. The idea is how we have placed all these objects on the slide to make a perfect circular spin for each of them. This animation is a complete replica of one of the animations by AM at codepen.io. We will begin by opening the animation and selection panes, and then showing all the first four layers, Apple text, Apple logo, big rounded corner rectangle 1 and 2. Out of these four shape objects, three are static and the spin effect has been applied to the big rounded corner rectangle 2. We are rotating this rectangle at 360 degree clockwise with a time duration of 18 seconds and repeating until the end of the slide. You can apply any fill color combinations, but don't forget to apply the transparency, so when it animates during the slideshow then we may see through the rectangles. Now, let's talk about the 8 large circles, which have been placed on top of each other again with a 50% color transparency. You can turn on the guides from the View tab to see the center point of the slide. In the animation pane, you can see that all the circles have a spin animation effect applied to them with 360 degree clockwise rotation and a time duration of 8 seconds. Here we used a trick to spin the circles in the direction that we want. Otherwise, if you draw a circle and apply the spin effect to it then during the slideshow you may not notice any movement in the circle. However, you can change the outline style to see the movement. Another thing is that the circle is moving from its center point, whereas we want to rotate the circle from slide center or from a point that we want. If you investigate the selection pane on the first slide, then you can notice that all the small and big circles are group objects and they have been grouped with another oval which you don't see on the slide. That is because they have been made invisible by using no fill and no outline. If I select any of these circles and change the outline color, then you will start seeing another oval, or if I select all these shapes at once and change their outline color, then you will see how each of the shapes has been grouped with another shape to have a custom anchor point. You can also watch my video on how to define custom anchor points for more information. So, to rotate a circle from a specific point, we grouped that inside another oval to have a different anchor point so that we may rotate from the position that we want. We applied the same method on all the 8 big circles. Now let's talk about the small circles. We used the same custom anchor point technique on the small circles as well, but we placed them inside a hollow shape because we wanted to rotate them around the big circles. You can either place all the four ovals inside a single hollow shape or can group each with a separate one. We also used the hollow shape for the small rounded corner rectangles to rotate them around the big circles. You can note down the rotation and timings of each animation effect by double-clicking on the effect in the animation pane. Finally, turn on all the layers and see the slideshow, and there you have a nice Apple logo animated background animation ready to use in PowerPoint. I hope you will find this tutorial useful and informative.